So hello, I've been wanting to do like a vlog for a long time now. I know I haven't updated in a while. So I want to keep you all updated, okay? Some people follows me on Instagram or even TikTok because I'm doing TikTok now, which is super funny. I don't even know if I'm supposed to say that, but it's amazing. Like I have so much fun with TikToks. I'm gonna see if I can try to get some TikTok videos in here. If not, I will just link them somehow, okay? Because clearly I have a bunch of fun with them, right? Okay.
I see assholes like you every day.
Every fucking day.
Let's go to Vegas. We'll all get drunk and
Yeah!
lay.
Woo!
Woo-hoo! Let's steal a cop car because it'll be really fucking funny.
Yeah! Think you gonna get away with it? Not up in here!
Not up in here!
Courtney, what the f is up with your Wi-Fi? You have this big ass house and you can't afford a Wi-Fi box out here?
It's not about affording, it's about radiation.
You're gonna die anyway. You understand that, right? Die with a good Snapchat going through. What the f?
Got a text from my ex the other day, said he missed me. I said, I'm sorry, I can't talk right now, I'm at a funeral. He said, oh my God, who died? I said, my feelings for you did, bye fucker.
Stop taking my chips! Stop taking my chips, okay?
Okay.
Let me tell you, last time I wrote, I was in Las Vegas. I came home back to Texas. I was in Vegas for like 3 days, no, 4 days actually, for the 10X conference with Elena Cardone, which was absolutely amazing. And then I went back to Texas. A couple of days afterwards, I went to Washington, Seattle to go to a Vipassana. Vipassana. It's a 10-day meditation course in silence, and it was absolutely amazing. Like, it was probably the best thing I've ever tried in my life. Like, I was scared. I had, I didn't have much expectations. I've heard people that have done it before, but I really wanted to come there with like no expectation at all and just try it and give it everything I had, like all I had, because I went in there and I, for a couple of months, been feeling very lost, to be honest, like far away from myself, like my inner goals, what is my purpose, what is the meaning, sometimes we get those feelings, or maybe you don't, but I did. And I'm 28 years old. I don't have any kids. I do have a dog and I have a husband, which I love very much, and I live in Costa Rica. It's nothing that I can complain about. It's really not. It was just that I felt lost and far away from myself. Like, what do I stand for? What do I want? Like, who am I today? Life just goes around in circles, like routines after routines, and then in the middle of everything, you're trying to figure out who you are and what you want to be and like your purpose and stuff. And I felt like I needed to take a break. I needed to get in myself and quiet my mind, that speaking mind that we have in our head. I call it the inner saboteur, okay? My mind used to be very loud. Like, it could make up scenarios, problems, you name it, crazy things every day. Like, I could wake up in the morning and I was like, today I have an anxiety. Why? What's going on? Why is my mind talking to me about all this crazy stuff? I don't even know what it comes from, to be honest. And that was really bothering me. And I have so many techniques and tools and everything that I used towards it, but it was trying, like, it was getting all of my energy, you know, like focusing on doing tools all the time, like what's going on? I just need a break. So I chose to go there for 10 whole days in silence, not speaking to anyone, not doing gestures to anyone, not even opening your mouth, saying anything, except 2 minutes a day you have for talking to the teacher, the meditation teachers, right? And you meditate for 10 hours and 45 minutes a day. Let me rephrase that. You meditate for 10 hours and 45 minutes a day? Okay, so now we made that clear. It killed me almost the first couple of days. It did, because it was so new to me sitting down. Like my I had pain in areas you can't even imagine that you knew that you could have pain in. My mind was wandering in the craziest places I've ever been. You know, like future, past, you know, you name it. I've been there in my mind while I was trying to meditate and focusing on my breathing. Also, we went up at 4 o'clock each morning. It was a gong, which is like boom, boom. Gong wakes you up each morning at 4 o'clock, and you go and meditate for 2 hours, and then you can have your breakfast. For somebody like me, who is the most grumpiest little piece of sh in the world in the mornings, this was very hard. I was sitting there for 2 hours, and my stomach was like, rawr. Not only that, you cannot eat after 11 o'clock a.m. Let me reframe that one more time. You're not allowed to eat any type of food after 11 a.m., 11 in the morning. So you go the whole night without food. But you do have, I must say, you do have a tea break at 5 o'clock. And you can have fruit. So that's your last thing that you put in your stomach. But saying all these things, it might sound negative. It wasn't. It got me discipline. It got me motivation to keep going. It got me to realization that I could actually do this. Then, you know, why go back and be like eating chips every night, you know, like, not because I do that. I'm very healthy, but you know, like, you have to eat at 8 o'clock at night at dinner, you know, like, I got so much discipline, motivation to just change my habits and routines, really. I learned how to sit for 1 hour straight in the same position without moving, not itching, not fixing my hair, not moving a finger for one whole hour. And that made me so proud of myself. On the fifth day, we had to exercise this every time we were sitting for 1 hour sessions, which was three times a day. Okay, sorry, it was our super nice cleaning lady. She was just about to leave. So anyway, I totally forgot where I was. I'm sorry, guys. I might cut this off later, I don't know. Yeah, okay, so I was sitting for 1 hour straight. So on the fifth day, we were starting to practice to sit 60 minutes three times a day, three sessions a day for 60 minutes without moving. It's about discipline, and it's also about getting into the meditation to feel your sensation on your body. Anyway, I can talk about this for hours. I know I'm up to 7 minutes right now, and I don't know how much you want to listen to me. So I'm going to just cut it up and take different sessions and parts and tell you more about it as I go, okay? But I will recommend Vipassana to anybody who just wants to change their lives, to be honest. Like, just change the smallest things of your life. Like, you have to go through your past. I mean, you go through memories. It just automatically comes up and you let it go, really. Goenka, our teacher, tells us about sankharas, which is old emotions that you have reacted to in the past, and you experience them as you meditate there, because it's so intensive, and you let it go. you just let it go. So I felt so much lighter coming out from there. I observe my emotions much better. Like, I can still feel sad. Of course, I can still feel angry and stuff, but I can also think that it starts with a thought in my mind, and then it becomes a sensation somewhere in my body. And when I connect them to, I can be like, okay, I had a thought, that thought created something in my body. Like, when I get mad, I start breathing very short, and I can feel like tension in my hands and stuff. If I just focus on the breathing and let myself be in that emotion and not trying to run away from it, it goes away. You know, nothing is really permanent. Everything is constantly changing. We are constantly changing. No feelings, no state is ever going to be permanent and last forever. It's just a state of the moment, basically. And I really learned that, and it made me handling life as it is today much, much easier. You know, like, back in the day, I'm not gonna lie, I used to, you know, get very upset very easily, or get very sad very easily, and, you know, reacting to situation in life very much. I used to have a lot of anxiety. It's crazy. I can still feel the sensation of anxiety sometimes, like very rare, very, very rare to feel it. But it goes away in just seconds because I can connect it with a thought that I had in my mind. Something triggered it, and then I had a sensation in my body, and it goes away. It's crazy how you can just be in that moment and accept it and be like, you know what, this is not going to be permanent. So you just stay in that, and then it actually goes away. This is my husband, by the way. Honey.
Hi.
I'm creating a vlog.
I finished.
Good job. Everybody clap their hands for you right now. Oh my gosh.
Okay, I finished with it.
You want to play the PS4?
Wait. No. I'm going to finish the thing.
Okay. Yeah, so, I mean, if you're going to do a vlog, at least show the real you in your real life. And this is also Samben. Sambia. Samben. Hola, bebe. Hola, babuni. Hola. She's so tired of me and my voice. I mean, who isn't? No, but seriously. Oh my gosh, I'm just like cracking up on myself. But seriously, so much I can just talk about. But I just wanted to share this because I like vlogs a little bit better, because I think that you getting closer to me and see the real me much better than when I write and just post pictures. It's funny, I like to write, but I also like to do videos sometimes. So please let me know if you like me to do more vlogs than just writing, and I will keep doing so. And I will also try to edit and take more videos from life here in Costa Rica and just the travels and whatever I'm doing, and just trying to put it in, because this vlog is just about me talking here in my room. But I want to show you also, because it's kind of like the sunset right now. It's kind of beautiful. See? So this is Samben. Yeah, okay, so Husby just said, like, oh, we can see it so much better over here. So if you're on TikTok, by the way, you should add me.
The sunset is better
for this. Yeah, I will show. Baby, am I name on TikTok Isabel Rodriguez or Izzy Rodriguez?
I think you changed it.
I think I changed it to Izzy Rodriguez _. Sorry, I will just link it down here. Okay, I just recently changed it, and I have kind of like bad memory sometimes, but it's okay. Just love the view. There is my yoga mat. So I'm gonna tell you about, so you get an idea. Okay, so this is my morning routine. I think morning routines are super important.
Izzy Rodriguez _.
Okay, good. So it's Izzy Rodriguez _ on TikTok. Okay. Okay, thanks. Okay, so guys, so to get something good from this video, except for me chattering, Morning routines. I can so recommend morning routines. I mean, it's so important to start the day, you know, depending on, you know, sometimes you can wake up and you can be sad, mad, stressed, anxiety, I don't know. You can wake up on any side, but if you have a great morning routine, you can change that completely in just like an hour. Not even an hour. I'm over saying it here, but I do a long morning routine now because I can. Back in the day, I couldn't because I had an 8-to-5 job and I had to go up super early and go to bed super, super early. So for me, it wasn't, you know, going up and do a morning routine of 2 hours. It didn't work. And I know a lot of people have kids and stuff. But a morning routine is super important. So I go up at 6 o'clock each morning. I take Sambia out. It takes like 15 minutes. And then I come up and I do meditation for 65 minutes. After that, I do a short yoga routine of 10 minutes. 10 minutes morning stretch yoga with Cassandra on YouTube. Look her up. She's fabulous. She's absolutely amazing. After that, I do my gratitude and my affirmation. So gratitude, I write in my book, my little notebook, what I'm grateful for each morning and each day. It could be anything from I'm grateful for this meditation I've learned and how I use it in my daily life and how I get the strength to get better each day. Or it could be I'm super grateful for my family and that, you know, they're healthy. It could be anything. Just write anything that you're grateful for there and then. Like here now. And I mean, it's always something that you're grateful for. It must be always something. I have a roof over my head. I have food in my refrigerator. I have water running. I have two legs to walk on. I don't know. You're grateful for something. I mean, you have to, right? And affirmation is when you tell what you want for the future. Like, I want to be in award-winning author. That is actually on my affirmation. And I became an award-winning author. So I'm just going to say that 85% of my affirmation that I wrote 3 years ago has come true. 85%. And I read that out loud to the nature out there, to the universe, each morning out loud. I don't care if my neighbors hear me. I don't care if they think I'm crazy. They probably heard it so many times because I'm there every morning to say my affirmation. And 85% of that affirmation has come true. Economically, work-wise, and personal growth-wise. I do believe in the law of attraction, absolutely. What you give out, you will get in. Like, what you think about the most will happen sooner or later because you give it out to the universe. And positive thoughts always win over negative thoughts. So if you haven't seen The Secret, it's on Netflix. I think you should see it. I'm also a very spiritual person, you would say. I have become more and more spiritual as the years goes by. Get to know myself in there, you know. It's so much more than just my mind. It's so much more than just my body, you know. It's just something that I get to borrow in this life. I do believe in reincarnation. It's so many things in the Buddhist that I do believe in. So I would say that. And so I can just go on and talk and talk and talk. But morning routines are super important. Just find your own time. If it's 15 minutes before this meditation course, I used to do only 20 minutes a day. And it's the 10-minute yoga and then my affirmation, my gratitudes. And then 2 minutes I read a book or listen to an audiobook just to keep my mind, you know, flowing. And I always listen to audiobooks that can teach me something, that self-grow books, you know, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, something like that, just to keep me going and motivated each and every day. And then I do a small exercise. Like, I do 10 squats, I do 10 sit-ups, and I do 10 push-ups. And that's it. It doesn't take more than 20 minutes each morning. I mean, if you just skip that 20 minutes of sleep and just go up and just do it on your balcony, in your living room, wherever it can be, it will change your day. It had changed my day. And all of my clients that I work with, I always give them like homeworks to do as a morning routine, so they get up and they start their day the best way possible, because it's so important. I cannot say it enough times. It's so important. So if you want to learn more about Vipassana, you can search about it on internet. They have a website. I will link it down below. If you would like to go to one of them courses, it's also for free. You pay at the end of the course if you want to pay for a donation, which I did because I thought it was absolutely life-changing. And I think that they deserve it, absolutely. It's more like I came there because somebody in the past have paid, you know, paid a donation to them. That's why I could go. So I wanted to, you know, pay it forward, really. And also a book I'm reading right now, I'm going to show you. I don't know why I'm always getting so exhausted. Just walking here. Just give me a second, I'm gonna pause. So, hold on. Yes. Okay, so, Cuenca. This course summaries of S.N. Cuenca. So, this is the guy, the teacher of the Vipassana. You don't get to meet him, and so he's fortunately passed away, but he's on all the discourses that you can see at night. At 8 o'clock at night, we always watch a discourse with this guy, and he's amazing. He's so funny, and he just teach you about this meditation. A very good explanation. So if you want to learn more about it, you should get this book, and I will also link the website down below. So I'm gonna go right now, and I wish you all have a good morning, good evening, wherever you are in this world. I will keep you more updated, and please, if you like this video, like it and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also subscribe to my blog so you get updated every time I post. And if you like me to do more vlogs, please tell me so, and I will do so. Check out my TikToks, by the way, if you want to laugh. Okay. Bye now.